I think about the day I met the perfect stranger. I think about us. And I think about the day I got wrapped around your finger. I think about us. The sun was shining on you. The Lord was smiling on me. And love was calling us. I had my mind made up. And I can't stop loving you. I can't help myself. And I can't get over you. No matter what I tell myself.
Friends and family, we're gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of two very special people who come here as family and friends to share the joy of Onika and Jabbar's wedding and to witness this outward expression of their love. To this moment, Onika and Jabbar bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure to share with each other. They bring that particular personality and spirit which is uniquely their own, and out of which will grow the reality of their continued life together. Let us rejoice and celebrate them as we witness this union of their hearts and their spirits, a union created by love, respect, and friendship for each other. May the blessings of this moment be shared by all, and may our thoughts and prayers be supportive of this special union. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Onika and Jabbar, you are beginning a new life together, a life based on the faith, hope, and love. This love has grown from friendship into marriage. And will be the cord that will bond your lives together. This commitment you're making is one that will be shaped by trust, respect, honesty, and faithfulness to each other. It is a relationship grounded in caring for each other and being cared for by each other, picking each other up when you fall, and standing beside each other in whatever experiences may come your way. Central to all of this will be respecting each other's uniqueness and differences, even when you do not agree, striving always to work out problems and not to create them. It will mean supporting each other, assuring that you each continue to grow, not only as a couple, but as unique and special individuals. For in this, your relationship will be made richer. Remember always that it is the little things that mean the most, the gentle touch, that certain look, those reassuring words. The love that you have for each other will unite your love. Love is capable of unifying individuals in such a way as to complete and fulfill them by what is deepest in themselves. It is the means of growing together, and indeed, the reason for doing so. Let your marriage be a covenant of faith, hope, and love. This covenant of faith, hope, and love is to be entered into only by those who are willing to accept seriously and reverently such a commitment. And therefore, I ask you following pledge to each other. Jamar, will you take Onika to be your wedded wife? Will you love her, comfort her, protect her, and respect her in difficult times as well as joyful times? Will you be patient, caring, and thoughtful of her? Will you strive to understand her needs and wants? Support her as she grows. Will you remind Onika of how much you love and value her? And will you be faithful to her and to her both blood, be both lover and friend through each day of your lives together? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Onika, will you take Jabbar to be your wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, protect him, and respect him in difficult times as well as joyful times? Will you be patient, caring, and thoughtful of him? Will you strive to understand his needs and wants and support him as he grows? Will you remind Jabbar of how much you love and value him? And will you be faithful to him and be to him both lover and friend through each day of your lives together? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Now, because of the love you two have for each other, please join your right hands and repeat these wedding vows. This signify your complete commitment to each other. I, Jabbar.
Take you, Onika.
To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse.
For
richer or for poor.
In
sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
I, Onika.
Take you, Jabbar. To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor. In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live. May I have the rings? The shape of the wedding ring has two meanings. As a perfect, symmetrical, and unbroken form, it represents unity. Thus, in marriage, it stands for the joining of two lives in one perfect union, as a figure with no beginning and no end. This ring. This ring represents eternity. It becomes a reminder to Anika and Jabbar that their love for each other is an eternal one. A love to remind them of an unbroken devotion to each other. So, Jabbar, repeat after me. Onika. With this ring,
I be wed,
and pledge my constant faithfulness,
and everlasting love.
Onika, repeat after me. Jabbar.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
And pledge my constant faithfulness.
And everlasting love.
Onika and Jabbar, may your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitement a marriage brings. And may life grant you both patience, tolerance, and understanding. And may God bless you and your marriage. And may he help you both to bear witness to the reality of the love that you have pledged for each other today. And therefore, with the authority vested in you, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your wife. I would now like human to candle. Life is the essence of our existence. Each one of us possesses an inner glow that represents our hopes, our dreams, and aspirations in life. Groom and bride, the two distinct candle flames represent your lives before this day. Individual, unique, and special. Please take the candle, symbolizing your life before today, and together, light the center candle. It's my honor to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Jamar Gibbons.